Today we will do free fall lifeboat. Now in the early 90s, lot of bulk carriers sank very quickly, and because of that lot of seafarers were killed. So SOLAS decided to make free fall lifeboat compulsory on all new bulk carriers, new buildings, because the advantage of free fall is it takes only less than 1 minute for launching compared to 6 minutes for the side launched lifeboats. So let's see what are the other advantages of free fall. This is one of the advantages. Second advantage is that even in rolling, vessel rolling up to 15 degrees, these lifeboats can be launched. The other lifeboats, side launched lifeboats, if vessel is rolling less than 5 degrees, they can be launched. So for the other lifeboats, side launched lifeboats, in case vessel is rolling more than 5 degrees, then what is the option you have? Only life rafts to be launched. And life rafts in cargo ships have sufficient capacity for everyone on board. So free fall lifeboat, when it became compulsory, it was required by SOLAS to be launched by free fall method every 6 months. But this had two problems. First was, when it used to hit the water with an impact and then come up. So here the impact was depending on the height and the number of people sitting in the boat, the weight of the lifeboat, etc. So with this impact, lot of crew members at the back of their neck, they used to get some injury. So that was the first thing, injury. Whenever you launch this by free fall method, there was a chance of injury to crew. And the second problem was, when the boat used to hit the water at the point of impact, it is normally made of fiberglass. So over the months or over the years, the fiberglass used to get some cracks. So that was the second problem. So after a few years, SOLAS changed this regulation. They said no need for free fall. No need for free fall, except in emergency. If you have less time, you can use free fall method. So only in emergency. Actual abandoned ship, if there is less time. And for lowering and maneuvering during the drills, now SOLAS has made, instead of every 6 months, it has made it every 3 months, but by recovery crane. So there is a recovery crane which you can also use it for lifting the boat and putting it in the water. And later the crew can board the lifeboat by ladder. So this was allowed. Now the side launched lifeboats, later on they came with one more capability, that was on load release. So one lifeboat starboard, one port, and now in on load release, the boat is lowered till it is about 1 to 2 meters above the water, and then it is let go by gravity. So what is the advantages of, when will you use on load? when the ship is having some speed, when your vessel is having speed, let's say whatever 6, 7 knots, and you want to abandon the ship quickly before the ship can be stopped, because ship will take some time to stop. Now, why you want to abandon quickly? Maybe there is a chance of explosion, or the ship is sinking fast. You don't want to wait. So then you use onload. Lower the lifeboat 1 to 2 meters from the waterline. Keep the engine ready. Give ahead movement, full ahead, and lower it by onload. And second reason you will use onload is when the sea is rough. Sea is rough, but vessel is rolling less than 5 degrees, you can launch these boats. But if you launch it by the normal method, as soon as the boat touches the sea, she will start rising up and down and difficult to let go the hooks. And when you let go the hooks, they might hit the boat. So you use onload release. So these are the benefits of onload release. Now again, SOLAS has changed the regulation because of the two defects of the free fall lifeboats. Now it is up to the owners that he can opt for new building bulk carriers, either side launched lifeboats or free fall.